8 waves. Dude, where's my religious guard? Did I just die? Start this, but see how we go. I'm out of stone soon, man. Come over here. Set this up soon. Oh, there's like a way up here. Oh, shit. What the fuck? What? As if I didn't like notice or see that at all. Fire Lancer. Use area damage. So they got like crazy range stuff as well. They like smash through. Let's see. So I can't really do the usual and like heal. So definitely gonna block the same places I did. Just need more units, ranged preferably, like heaps of range. I don't really know Chinese at all right now, so I don't know what's like the units, the unit setup there, even their civ setup. Go.
Song defector, General Lu Zheng, advised Kublai Khan, that the best strategy to take Shangyang was to construct a blockade, completely cutting it off. Lu Zheng led the Mongol army to the trade route at Lumenshan and set his plan in motion. The general's plan depended on recruiting local workers who could build defenses. The first step was to eliminate the Song garrison near the village of Lumen.
No, I don't remember everything. I think there was a there's a chest down here. This is a second town.
The Mongol army tore through the Song garrison, and with these guardians removed, the people of Lumen gave their support to Lu Zheng and Kublai Khan. Controlling Lumen allowed Lu Zheng to employ Chinese tactics and equipment, including the construction of stone walls. He ordered the people to build walls to block the roads north, cutting off Shangyang from the rest of the Song.
Let's set this quickly. Other instance and that. Get rid of these two. One second, sorry. Alright, what are we at here? Down here.
Of Lumen reported that the village of Boheko, located to the west, would also welcome Lu Zheng's arrival. If the general could get forces to Boheko, it would add both an economic and military boost to his blockade.
Oh, such a huge forest over here, so...
Bohiko not only welcomed Lu Zheng's men, but members of the local militia even defected to the Mongol cause.
Damn it! Stop saving so often so I can actually just smoothly play. You don't check... Stupid game doesn't checkpoint anyway. Some reason they chose to go there. Oh wait, no.
Stout walls now blocked off the first of the major routes to Shangyang.
I really don't need to like even make a gate right in my mind. That's gonna make defenses. Oh, I can go up here. God, wait, no, they can't. Yeah, they stops. Yeah, the forest stops there. Bro, are you fucking kidding me, man? Fuck, man. You kidding me? Good.
Liu Zheng's vision was complete. The Mongols' great blockade now cut off the Song cities. However, the Song commanders would not leave Shangyang to stand alone and sent forces to break through the Mongol barrier.
Okay.
Song forces descended on Liu Zheng's men. The general needed to defend what he had taken from his former masters.
All my guys died. They just like to constantly attack.
Stop.
Fire Lancer. I need wood. Makes sense to have like so little of it. Oh my lord. Dude, man, this is crazy. I don't really know what to play here because my guys keep getting killed. My villagers. So maybe the play is to like build the the towers and shit, I don't know. I need to like constantly send guys down to repair. Shit like that. Even as a defensive player, I don't know how to sort this, man. How to do this, really. There's way more wood next time. I don't have any units here to defend me. I need way more units. I need way more units, dude. God damn, dude. I mean, I've done four waves. But I don't have any units to go down. Okay, let's restart. Let's focus more on wood again. Food and wood, and then I got enough on stone. Like, my stone is like kind of decent. Don't really need to worry about gold, only for units, but I think quantity over quality here, because I just don't have enough units to defend the goddamn wall. So, I don't mind the forward camps I did, but I need more. Probably have them in different positions, like having them on the way to the camp instead of back.
The general's plan depended on recruiting local workers who could build defenses. The first step was to eliminate the Song garrison near the village of Lumen.
Oh, got fucked up. 48.
Mongol army tore through the Song garrison.
15.
And with these guardians removed, the people of Lumen gave their support to Lu Zheng and Kublai Khan.
6.
Controlling Lumen allowed Lu Zheng to employ Chinese tactics and equipment, including the construction of stone walls. He ordered the people to build walls to block the roads north, cutting off Xiangyang from the rest of the Song.
5.
People of Lumen reported that the village of Bohiko, located to the west, would also welcome Lu Zheng's arrival. If the general could get forces to Bohiko, it would add both an economic and military boost to his blockade. Not only welcomed Lu Zheng's men, but members of the local militia even defected to the Mongol cause.
Oh,
walls now blocked off the first of the major routes to Shangyang.
Wasn't big enough to have defenses on there. Lu Zheng's vision was complete. The Mongols' great blockade now cut off the Song cities. However, the Song commanders would not leave Shangyang to stand alone and sent forces to break through the Mongol barrier. Okay.
Song forces descended on Lu Zheng's men. The general needed to defend what he had taken from his former masters.
God damn it, man. I'm just so low on, like, people, you know?
Thank you.
need more wood. That's for sure. Melee cavalry, just lances. Specialist. We get some of those. All purpose range, infantry high damage, high cost, slow movement. Five gold ferocious damage potential against enemy units. Range, targeted by infantry armor.
Thank you.
thought I wasn't going to be able to do it eventually, but man. Just go from what archers on there and heal as best you can. Trade route at Lumenshan,
cutting off Shanyang from the south. Thanks to the insights of General Lu Zheng, Kublai Khan's plan to weaken the Great Song Fortress was working.
Sweet. Man, how many more missions to go? Holy crap, dude. I feel like I've got me near the end. That's, how much did I... How did we do, like, 3? Already? Okay, this is the last one. Alright. Sweet. My stone was of Zhang Zhang met the immense power of the great trebuchet in the final stand of the Song Fortress. Alright, last one, guys.
Crippled by the loss of their supply route,
don't have to go overtime.
Shanyang and Feng Cheng were ready to fall. The Mongols' new long-range trebuchets would test the mighty walls of the Song Fortress, and Kublai Khan would not stop the bombardment until he sat on the throne of all China.
Kublai Khan's siege engineer Ismail brought with him a devastating new trebuchet. With this mighty weapon, he could strike the fortress with force like no other. Oh, it's like a new and improved, like a completely different one. What? If it's these ones, it looks like it has stone as a weight. All right, let's do this.
After years of resisting Kublai Khan's siege, Fan Cheng and Shangyang still refused to submit to Mongol rule. To take the cities, Kublai Khan would harness the full power of his empire by enlisting an ally from the Ilkhanate of Persia.
Persia? Huh.
Ismail, a siege expert, would lead the Mongol army in the construction of the Huihui Pao, an immensely powerful counterweight trebuchet.
The what now?
This new trebuchet, once constructed, could hurl boulders greater in size than any weapon before it. During the years-long siege, Kublai Khan had established lucrative trade routes with Chinese market towns who swore loyalty to him. Although these trade partners were vulnerable to Song attacks, they could deliver valuable resources to fund Ismail's efforts.
Construct the Huihui Pao, have enough traders to trigger Silk Road stone income. Silver Tree Landmark. And what's this? Southern allies. Defend your allies to maintain trade income. Okay. So I don't have any forces to... Well, I kind of do here. Alright, so... set up mine here. In here. The bridge is... Oh yeah, there's a second bridge down here? No. The map's kind of changed a little bit. I don't know where they would come from if they attack here. So, just... not see. Just sit there and see.
The Mongol commercial network could supply Ismail in stone so long as he had enough traders on the road.
And has a falcon you can spy on faraway enemies. area for 20 seconds. Not really sure what the point of that is, but... Jeez, that is quite siege engineering. Problems in walls are a great distance. Quite siege engineering, okay. Bring more traders to increase stone income.
Зүйтэй, хин дайчил хэрэгтвэ? Би танд барьж өгсөн. Цугаа хөдөл, туулах цам урт, бүгд сонс.